This idea of these radioligands, these lutetium-177. And so it's where you're tying in your PSMA scan with actual treatment, right? So can you tell us, because you use the word like vision and you use other trial names like therapy. Can you tell us where we are? There, we attach this PSMA reading to the idea of then giving a type of radiopharmaceutical, right? And then you can go after metastatic sites, but we don't have lutetium approved. It's only in a clinical trial. It's in a phase 3 trial called the Vision trial. But my understanding is that ends this year. Are you feeling pretty confident that this is a technology that has a good chance of approval in the next 12 months?
I'm knocking on wood here. So the Vision trial closed to recruitment a while ago, actually. I think a little over a year and a half ago, something like that. And we're waiting for the results to be published. And we're hoping maybe by ASCO, which is a big medical oncology conference in June, that might be the first time we see results presented from Vision. But that will be a huge trial. And if that data looks good, then yes, I think it'll be approved. The problem with Vision was it happened during COVID. So getting all the follow-up data and everything was difficult. And then the other problem was a lot of people on the control arm who were randomized to not getting the lutetium. Some of them got lutetium outside of the Vision trial. They went to Germany or Australia, or even tried to re-enroll in the Vision trial at different sites to try to get access to the lutetium PSMA. And that can obviously limit the power of the study and your ability to show a difference between the control arm, which didn't get lutetium, with the treatment arm that got lutetium. But my guess is it will be a positive study. And then that would lead to approval. So I'm hoping maybe by this time next year, lutetium PSMA 617 will be FDA approved.
For metastatic castrate-resistant prostate cancer patients, right? It would be another option in that setting, which would be amazing. But you're also doing trials, and I saw a whole list of them, of combining lutetium or this kind of technology with immunotherapy, you know, words like Keytruda, pembrolizumab. So these immunotherapy and all these other combinations with lutetium are going on now. Is there anything, could we see approval of these kind of things in the next few years, or a phase 3 trial of these combinations? Or are we still a long way away from combining lutetium with immunotherapy or with PARP inhibitors, or who knows? What do you think?
I think we're a bit away. So, you know, there's a phase 1 trial at UCSF with pembrolizumab. There's a similar phase 1 trial at Peter MacCallum Institute in Australia. There's also a phase 1 trial with a laparib, a PARP inhibitor combination. Once, let's say those phase 1 trials read out and look pretty, let's say they look really positive. Well, then you got to run probably a phase 2 or just skip to a phase 3 trial to get eventual combination approval, which is not going to be trivial. So that's probably a 4 to 5 year process. So you're talking a long time from now, 6-7 years from now, before anything approved. But you know, things take time. Trial enrollment in 2016, 17, maybe 2017, and so we're still waiting approval. It'll be 2022 before it gets approved. So this is just the way the pace of science